So first, we're enormously excited about converged TV. Obviously, it's a time of a lot of change in the marketplace, and with change comes opportunity for both advertisers and for technology companies like ours that are supporting them. I think what's most important as we start the conversation is to recognize that that change starts with the consumer. The reason CTV is important and is because consumer behavior has changed and is changing at a fairly rapid rate. Converged TV has been sort of coming for a long time, but there was a huge acceleration with the pandemic when folks were forced to spend more time in their homes under lockdowns, and things like going to the movies as a way for us to consume our entertainment were taken away from us. And so we saw an unusual confluence of factors that brought the streaming services to prominence just at a time when consumers were looking for new ways to consume content. And the result of that has been a massive shift of eyeballs from linear TV to streaming. And that has a whole cascade of implications for us as marketers. Not just the fact that the eyeballs have moved, but that there's very different characteristics to the streaming experience than there is to the linear advertising experience. There's far lower ad load in aggregate, far fewer ads per hours of programming, and large swaths of streaming services have no ads at all. And then where there are ads, there's a very different level of consumer engagement in this content where people tend not to just put it on as background noise, but have a much higher focus on the content that they're consuming. They've chosen when to consume it on their terms, and therefore engagement is very, very different. So you've got this massive shift of eyeballs and some very different characteristics to the medium that's holding the advertising. And that's forcing advertisers to ask a series of new questions. How do I maximize the reach of my audience between linear and converged TV? How do I think about creative differently in this environment? Or do I need to think about it differently? Are there things that I can learn in these CTV environments that can be brought back into my linear buys? And then there's the broader question of digital video overall, because for all of the focus and excitement around CTV, far more video is consumed on digital channels that are not TV than they are on CTV today. So there's a lot of change, a lot of complication, underlied by foundational changes in consumer behavior, and advertisers are trying to catch up. So that's opportunities for publishers, and it's opportunities for Mediaocean.
Now, of course, Mediaocean has been deeply involved, certainly through the 4C days in social video. That's continues to grow. What are the opportunities around social video, and sort of how are you guys playing there? And what is some advice that you're giving and trends that you're seeing?
Well, the first thing about social video that we think about is, again, that the environment surrounding the video creates some different creative demands and opportunities. In social, you see a lot more short-form video, 6 and 7 second videos versus longer form videos that you're used in TV. But also, there's a diversity of environments across the social platforms. It's one thing to just think about Facebook, but as soon as you think about advertisers that are spending their social money across Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Snap, Pinterest, those are all different environments that require different takes in order to maximize the impact of the video. And that creates executional challenges. I think there's a general theme today in marketing overall that this massive fragmentation of media creates all kinds of media planning challenges, but even more acute are the challenges to creative and production. I've got a basic piece of video that I want to get out into the market, but now how do I tweak that piece of video for maximum impact in an environment that is skippable after 6 seconds, or not skippable and restricted to 15 seconds, or is an actual 6 second unit? We're attacking this problem through our ad studio platform, which is now with coming together in with Mediaocean, we've expanded to be able to support all the social channels. So through one creative platform, you can create your open web ads, your social ads, and video ads that span across all of those different formats in a coordinated way so that you can understand a core creative message's performance across those different environments and tweak it in, through templates and AI to make sure that you're putting the best expression of that piece of creative into the best environment for the most success. There's also then the trafficking complexity that comes along with that in order to make sure that the right assets get to the right places. But of course, the flash talking ad serving environment has always been about maximizing the creative delivery, even for dynamic elements. And so we've extended that capability into dynamic social video as well. So if you want to, you can do dynamic video across all of the social platforms using the flash talking ad studio and ad serving platform.